who's already qualified for Rio, is up against a real puzzle in the shape of Kazakhstan's Yelusinov.
Intriguing, this one. Yelusinov has obviously got the credentials coming in as a reigning world champion, and just does everything he needs to do to get the contest won without looking spectacular somehow. But in his last fight, he started nearly looking the part as well as being effective. And then Rabi, what an aggressive, pretty tall box puncher, hasn't he? He'd rather have a fight than a boxing match, though, wouldn't he? You can see that.
Yeah, we like watching him. We like watching him indeed. He was in a crackerjack of a semi-final up against Wei Liu, the Chinese boxer. That was a terrific one. He made a little bit more hard work of it than you might have expected on the seedings. Liu only just inside the top 50, but the Moroccan fans have such high expectations of Rabi, and he has the opportunity, just like Michael Conlan last night, of carving his own piece of international boxing history. Just the possibility that he could become the first Moroccan male world boxing champion.
Yeah, he's been one of my favourites from this tournament, Rabi, as far as being fan-friendly. Style of boxing really is good to watch. But you can't hit what's not in front here, and that is what he may find tonight with Yelusinov.
He's got massive support here tonight, Rabi. The big question is, can he get to Yelusinov? Can he catch him? Because he's up against a real genie in the lamp in the space of, in the shape of this Kazakh champion. Yelusinov in the red, Rabi in the blue.
Both.
And here we go. Fantastic atmosphere building for this one.
Just trying to figure out what tactics Rabi could employ against Yelusinov. He's obviously got the quicker feet and he's an accurate puncher, but Rabi, Abby's a really good puncher, sets his feet when he lets them go. The problem is, once he sets his feet, Yelusinov will be out of the way. So, you can see there.
Stop! Important, I think, that Rabi moves his feet tonight if he's going to have any success at all against such an elusive target.
That's the one. He may have to sacrifice a little bit of the power in his shots just to land them.
Maybe he just cut his cloth according to what was required. The bout against Wei Liu in the semi-finals was just a slugfest.
Oh, it was great to watch.
Toe-to-toe. It was terrific to watch. I do think that Rabi's a bit better than he showed in that semi-final, and I think already he's showing it here tonight.
Look behind. Look red.
Yelusinov straight on the back foot, which Yelusinov is comfortable with. So he needs to land a shot while Yelusinov fires in with his own.
Fast there, Yelusinov. We're halfway through the first. He was outstanding against the number four seed Bagarov in the semi-final. That was as good as he's bulked the whole tournament so far, the reigning world champion.
Yeah, he seems to have got better as the tournament's gone on, Kazakhstan boxer.
Both of these guys have been pin-ups in their own way. Yelusinov, the AIBA Boxer of the Year in 2013 and 2014, 2 years running, he was the main man across the competitions. And Rabi himself, courtesy of those seven swashbuckling wins in the WSB, out of seven, was the WSB Boxer of the Year. And that was voted for by the fans on an internet poll.
Rabi came in on the attack a few moments ago. Yelusinov just spun off with a right hook, and Rabi, he nearly fell through the ropes. Really is a clever boxer, the Kazakhstan.
The atmosphere is as good as it's been. This is the best it's been at any time throughout this competition for this one. I don't know if South African fans are in full voice, trying to raise their man. They thought that was a genuine knockdown. Rabi's trying to apply the pressure.
Brilliant bit of defensive play again off the ropes from Yelushinov. Just the left shoulder, made the shot go over the top, and then he spun off and landed the shot of his own. Rabi getting successful now, yes, though, on the ropes.
Yeah, there was a left hook, and then you just saw that wild, wide right hand that landed as well.
I like Yelushinov's better boxing in that round, Alex.
But there was pressure, a lot of pressure from Rabi. This crowd are getting into it. He was coming forward, and Rabi's been given the vote on all three of those scorecards. It was a tough one. Rabi pressure, did he do enough? Yelushinov on the back foot, trying to counter.
It's a question of what you like, isn't it, with a round like that. I did prefer Yelushinov's skills and movement, but shot stole landed from Rabi.
That was a really fast sharp counter. He missed by a millisecond. Look at the concentration, yeah, on the face of Yelushinov.
That's one of his better chances, is to hold, if he's going to hold his feet and let the power shots go, do it when Yelushinov's committing with his own shot and coming in with the feet.
Both of these, the reigning champions in their respective confederations as well. Yelushinov winning the Asian Confederation Championship earlier this year, and the African Confederation Championship went the way of Rabi. It is the main men in their respective fields. It's the one and two seeds for the competition. They are matching each other punch for punch and stride for stride through this one into the second.
Yelushinov just landed with a good clean shot then. He's got on his bike. Rabi coming looking for him to respond.
Off a bit more mobile through the first 30 or so seconds of this round.
Very elusive, isn't he? Just the way he moves them feet, and then he lets the shots go after he's moved the feet, and it's classic boxing from Yelushinov.
I must admit, I expected this kind of movement from the first round.
Good shot from Rabi there. He walked onto that Yelushinov, and that's what I was saying. If he's going to land them power shots, do it when Yelushinov's on the way in.
Is terrific. The Algerians are in, the Moroccans are in full voice, and the Algerians are chipping in as well. Fantastic atmosphere here in Doha.
That punch has just been a little bit of a turning point, I think, in this round, because Yelushinov's not willing to commit as much as he's firing in with the feet.
There he goes again, Rabi. He is much more switched on in this bout than he has been previously. He looks faster, his counters are quicker.
That was a good right hand counter there. Just chopped it down. Oh, good shots again.
Big left hand there from Rabi.
And we haven't seen Yelushinov take anywhere near a clean shot like that all the way through the tournament. Again, as Yelushinov's coming in and committing with his own shots, Rabi is countering them to perfection. Yes. When he goes on the front foot, Yelushinov's too good at moving away from the shots, and he's punching fresh air a lot of the time on the front foot, so he's got his tactics bang on, I think.
Yeah, and his timing and his speed tonight has been impressive, Rabi. This is the best he's looked. First and second rounds of the competition, you thought Rabi was capable of this, and then that semi-final just had you wondering. It was a case of styles, isn't it?
Yeah, definitely. Styles make fights, don't they? And he's in a tough one in the semi-final. Thing is now, I think Rabi won that round. I like Yelushinov in the first, I like Rabi in that one. The question is, can Yelushinov go on the front foot after Rabi to try and take the third round? And I don't think he can. I think he's much more of a back foot boxer.
There's confirmation that Rabi's clear into an advantage with two rounds. He's the puncher of the pair too, and he landed some telling blows in that round. And The problem for Yelusinov is he stayed more in range in the first round. He tried to get on his bike in the second. Neither of them have worked.
Two solid shots.
Yeah, that's right, Alex. I haven't seen Yelusinov come on the front foot much at all in this tournament. And he's not going to be encouraged to do so because of the power he could be walking onto. So Rabi just needs to stay on his feet in this last round and he's going to be the world champion.
Piece of Moroccan boxing history is upon us.
I tell you what, he has been good to watch though, hasn't he, Alex Rabi? He's been entertaining.
Well, you and I posed a hypothetical question the other night when we were commentating on Lopez. Wouldn't you love to see Arlen Lopez, the middleweight champion, against this Moroccan Mohamed Rabi, obviously down at welterweight? Some sort of catchweight between that pair. That would be mouthwatering. Yelusinov might have just got out of danger and managed to land his own punch there.
See, Rabi as well, he's got that attitude. He always wants to go and look for the big shot. I think he'll be pretty much aware that he's up two rounds ahead, but it's not enough for him. He can, you know, he wants to do the damage every time he gets in the ring.
That's jab from Rabi.
Just looking for that counter. Again, as Yelusinov comes in with the left hand to the body, Rabi just tries to chop that right hand down onto the chin of Yelusinov.
It's been such a good competition for him. He was knocked out 2 years ago in the very first round. Youth world champion. Oh, big right hand from Rabi again and again.
That was the shot that he's been looking for and it finally landed.
It's all Rabi.
Watch out your head, Blue.
So he's starting to hurt Yelusinov now.
If he's gone out in the first round 2 years ago, it just shows how far he's come and how much he must have improved. I think he's got his tactics spot on in this fight, to be honest, Alex. He's waiting for Yelusinov to commit and landing his power shot as a counter because he's got good time and it's worked for him.
This is the best and the sharpest he's looked throughout the competition. There's no doubt about it, Rabi.
Left hook there as well. Again.
And you know what? He's only 22.
It's encouraging, isn't it? So much potential for even more improvement. Working the body well as well now in the last round, just
no
to
flipping, no flipping.
Add to the performance.
Morocco have only ever had two bronze medals in World Championship events in boxing. Two bronze medals. They're on the cusp of something quite magnificent.
Rabi's been involved in real tear-ups all the way through as well, so it goes to show the condition he must be in, because he's still in fantastic shape now.
And there he goes. He landed another right hand just before the end. Yelusinov has a look across. I think he knows that he's been beaten. And the Moroccans are celebrating as if gold is already theirs. I think in a few moments' time, it should be. Well, these championships have unveiled some talents. And this guy has to be on the shortlist.
Yeah, he's going to take the gold. And so far, for me, be out of him and Aaron Lopez, the middleweight from Cuba, who you've just mentioned as boxer of the tournament.
They were shouting and singing and bouncing and celebrating before. Now they really can start the party in a moment or so.
The winner on points in 2015 69 kilogram world welterweight champion from the blue corner representing Morocco.
Oh yes, what a celebration, what a moment for Mohamed Rabi, what a day for Morocco, the first ever boxing world champion. And what a celebration to go with it.
Give him a hand! Give him a hand!
Look at what it means to him. Look at what it means to them. And you just know how much it'll mean to the country back home.
Well deserved, wasn't it? And it's a name to remember in the future, because I think we're going to hear a lot more from Mohammed Rabi moving forward. He's got a big future ahead of him. He's already world champion. And that was a fantastic performance.